Good morning to one and all.
Welcome to this video lecture of Power Electronics and Instrumentation, module number 1, Introduction to the Power Electronics. Okay. So in my previous video lecture, we have just started with the introduction of our power electronics. Okay. What do you mean by the word electronics, and what do you mean by the term power? Okay. So the basic things what we need to learn here in power electronics is the things which are more helpful in the field of electronics. Okay, so basically what we think is, we all know about what is voltage, what is current. Okay, what do you mean by the potential difference? Okay, so this power electronic subject, in this what we will do is, we will study the concept behind the power electronics. Okay, what has made the industry, or what has made the fundamentals of electronics to switch from the basic electronics to the power electronics. Okay, so in my previous video lecture, I have just taken up the introduction to the power electronics and how the power electronics is getting involved in our today's daily life. In the sense, how rapidly the power electronics has been emerging, or how it has been going in a direction towards the industries, or you can say into the other fields of engineering. Okay, so now today we will more focus on the interdisciplinary nature of the power electronics. Okay, so the term interdisciplinary, in the sense, I will just give you an example here. If we are from the Department of Electronics and Communication, okay, we have other departments also, like electrical, okay, like mechanical, then civil engineering, computer science, okay, etc. Okay, now is there any relation, or is there any bonding, or is there any something beneficial things can be done at the other departments also? Okay, let me make you more clear. There is a single department called as power electronics itself. Power electronics has a separate branch, okay, where everything will be studied in detail. Okay, but we don't have such type of branch here. We only focus on the what is power electronics and how the power electronics is playing its role in other departments or in other. So here today we will see how this power electronics is going to help us in interdisciplinary nature of the power electronics. Okay, so what I was telling here is, if at all, okay, the theory behind the power electronics is used in other branch, okay, then they fall under the interdisciplinary concept. Okay, interdisciplinary concept. Okay, so let me make you more clear again here. Okay, just look at the diagram here. Okay, now what I have said is, the fundamental behind the electronics and the fundamental behind the power electronics, when I compare both these two different type of branches of electronics in terms of our voltage, in terms of power, or in terms of current. Okay, so very basically, the requirement of the electronics will be in terms of very small voltage. Okay, it will be in terms of millivolt. Okay, in terms of normal voltage also, 5 volt, okay, 2 millivolt, 3 millivolt, okay, in terms of milliamperes also. Okay, or sometimes it will be, when you measure in terms of the power, it will be in terms of few watts. Okay, few milliwatts. Okay, but now when the term comes, the power electronics here, it will be measured in terms of either megawatts or in terms of the gigawatts. Okay, you just simply take the engine, okay, the railway engine, it will be generating the huge amount of voltage in terms of kilowatts, in terms of kilowatts. Okay, so there are other different applications in the industries are available, where the availability of the power or the power requirement will be of very high range. Either it can be in terms of the megawatt, or it can be in terms of gigawatts. Okay, so therefore, if you look at this figure here, the range of power scale, okay, which are the different interdisciplinary parameters or interdisciplinary fields are related to the power electronics. Okay, we have electric machines, okay, where huge amount of power is required to run the machines. Okay, you take an example of the hydropower plant, it requires a huge amount of voltage, okay, just to run the turbines. Okay, then we have the power system. Power system is one field where the all the circuit elements will be will be arranged in a proper manner, and the amount of power which is required to run those systems, again, it will be very high. Okay. Then in terms of the electromagnetics, okay, then we have simply electronics. We have in terms of signal processing, system and control theory. Okay. We do have one subject called as the control system engineering. Okay. So there you can see how these systems can be well analyzed. Okay. In terms of their power or in terms of their requirement. Okay. Most of the power electronics fields, they will be based on the requirement of the company or the requirement of the industries. Okay. So industry will tell them that I require so and so power for my machinery to run. So therefore I need some circuitry where the voltage or the power, it should be stable. It should not be fluctuating. Okay. You know what happens when the current or the voltage or the power get fluctuates. Once the power get fluctuates from its voltage, it will damage everything. Okay. So therefore, based on the requirement, these systems are designed. Okay. And also circuit theory, solid state physics, and simulating and computing. Okay. So these are the various ranges where the power electronics can be helpful for the analysis, or simply you can say these are the interdisciplinary nature of the power electronics. Then where the power electronics is going to contribute, how? Okay, first is nothing but the electronics, that is nothing but dealing with the solid state devices and signal processing circuits. Okay, this solid state devices are nothing but your analog device circuits. Okay, these are the analog device circuits where you will be making use of the thyristor, okay, SCR, okay, then converters. Okay, these are the very important terminologies which are used in the power electronics. Okay, and some of them are in terms of the signal processing circuits. Okay, we have various signal processing circuits are available into the market. Okay, so the very best part of it is it's a DSP. It is called as digital signal processing. Okay, where there also the power will play an important role. Okay, then power system. It's a branch of electrical. Basically, it's a branch of electrical, but it deals with the static and rotor power equipment, because we may come across the very huge machinery where it requires the huge power for the rotating of your motor. Either it can be your AC motor or it can be your DC motor. Okay. You just take an example of the normal water motor, which we use in our homes to just to pump the water. Okay. What is the unit for that? It is in terms of the HP, that is horsepower. Okay, 1 HP, 0.5 HP, 1.5 HP, 2 HP, thing, right? So therefore, they contribute, these power systems will contribute in the static as well as in the rotor power equipment. Okay, then we have the control system. It deals with the steady state and the dynamic characteristics of the closed loop system. Okay, there is a whole subject in the fourth semester regarding the control system. Okay, so basically we learn the two important terminologies in the control system, that are one is the closed loop system and the another is nothing but the open loop system. Okay, so there are various advantages and the disadvantages with respect to the closed loop system and the open loop system. Okay, closed loop system is nothing but there will be some kind of a feedback in the system. Okay, if anything goes wrong, that feedback will give the input to the controller part, or it will give as a feedback that the output is not desired, the output is not correct. So therefore, I need to adjust my input supply such that the output will be obtained whatever we required. Okay, so that is nothing but the closed loop system. But in case of the open loop system, there will not be any kind of a feedback available in the system. So therefore, whatever you feed input to the system will give you the sum output. May not be the correct answer, but still it will give you the output. Okay, then the general structure of power electronics, how the power electronics is all about. Okay, the first important thing in the structure of the power electronics is nothing but the feedback. Is nothing but the feedback. If you just look at this the diagram, generalized diagram here, it is power input, this is power output. Okay, there is one controller. Okay, now what is the use of your controller? Is this controller will be acting as some commanding unit. Okay, it will give some command. It's a controller. Okay, it is just like whatever you give the control to the input devices, it will act. It will give that particular control to the main important circuitry. Okay, now what is the important circuit here? It's a nothing but it's a power converter. Okay, power converter, it can be any circuit. Okay, where you give the input to the power converter, it will give the desired output. Okay, just by converting from one form to another form. Okay, and what is the use of this feedback? Here you can see feedback or feed forward measurements of the output signal. Okay, so whatever the quantity when you measure at this particular point, okay, whatever the quantity you measure at this particular point, it may not be the correct answer. It may not be the correct answer. So therefore, what we will do is we will just take out the output of this power converter and just simply apply it to the controller part. Okay. So here your controller part has the another input which is called as a reference input. Okay. For what is the reference? What is the use of the reference input? Okay. For example, let us say that the reference is 5. The reference is 5, but the output of the power converter is how much? It is 4. It is 4. So what this will do, it will check whether that the output power is equal to 5 or not. It will check. If it is not equal, okay, then what it will do, it will give the input to the power converter that the output which is measured or which is compared at this particular point has a difference of 1 volt. So therefore, this power converter will again convert the input power and it will try to make it equal by 5. Okay. So this is how the power converter will work or the controller part will do. Okay. But there is another input which is applied at this particular converter. Here it is feed forward or feedback. It's a measurement of the input signal. Obviously, whenever you apply or you take a controller part, there should be an input also. Why input? Because your input is not constant. It will be always changing. It will be always varying. Okay. So therefore, whenever you apply the input to the controller, okay, this controller will also take into the consideration that for this so and so input, you are getting 4, but the reference is 5. So therefore, it should be made adjusted, or it will give some control input to the converter such that it should be made equal. Okay, so this is how the general structure of the power system or the power electronic system will work. Okay, then you can see the processor here. Okay, so in this particular processor here, again we have converter. This is the another diagram. Okay, this is another diagram where we have one converter, we have one control circuit or the triggering circuit. Okay, we will study in detail what do you mean by the triggering circuit. Okay, what are the different converters are available in the power electronics. Okay, I'm just going in a generalized format. This is just the topic related to the introduction to the power electronics. Okay, once I go in detail each and everything and each and every part or each and every section of the power electronics, then you will able to know how this power conversions takes place in the electronics part. Okay, so this is the diagram for the processor. Okay, you can see here it's a raw electrical power. Okay, then it's a feedback. Again, we do have a reference. Now this is the control circuit or it's a triggering circuit. Okay, this is the feedback, this is the power output, power input, and this is the converter. We don't know what type of converter is mentioned here. It's a general term they have written as a converter. Okay, and in the second diagram you can see the input is AC supply and output is a motor. Okay, output is the motor. Motor in the sense it can be your AC motor or it can be your DC motor based on the type of converter. Okay, if your power electronic system do not have a rectifier, then your output will be always equal to AC, not DC. That is why the reason they have mentioned it as AC motor. You just take example of your the motors which you are using in your home, which you use to pump the water. Okay, so that is nothing but your AC motor. Then they have used some two controllers and two converters. Okay, and this is the whole complete processor part, how the signals are processed. AC signal is processed in the power processor. Okay, and the history of power electronic devices. Okay, directly we do not jump. Okay, we do not jump to the power electronics. Okay, power electronics has just evolved a few decades. Okay, but earlier when you go back to the history or the prehistory of the power electronics, okay, there was only the electronics. Okay, but when you try to study the electronics parts, okay, many electronic devices we know. We know the very simple basic electronics. We have studied about the diode. Okay, we have studied only about the diode. But what was there before the diode? Is there any kind of a conversion used to take place between AC to DC? Or was there all the devices are working on the AC supply? Okay, there is no DC supply at all. Okay, so therefore, you need to study the prehistory. We call it as a prehistory. Before 1957, we represent it under the prehistoric part. But after 1957, this is the first phase of electronics, second phase, and the third phase. Okay, you can see the ranges from 1970s, 1980s. Okay, when the invention of thyristor has come, it is under 1957. Okay, the invention of thyristor, or simply you can call it as the invention of SCR, silicon controlled rectifier. Okay, then fast application for fast switching, fully controlled semiconductor devices. Okay, many devices we will study in the coming classes. Okay, this is just the brief out. Okay, you know what do you mean by the MOSFET. Okay, then you also know about the thyristor. Okay, so we use in microprocessors. Then we use in the DSP, digital signal processing. There is a whole subject called as a DSP in fifth semester. Okay, so in that particular subject DSP, we will try to analyze the things which we study in the basic part of our fourth semester. Okay, just try to remember, this is how the theory of the power history of power electronics devices will go on. Okay, we can see here there is a huge list. It is given. Okay, in 1882 Jasmine, okay, who was a French, she discovered the semiconductance. Okay, then Aaron, he is from Germany. He invented the first mercury air vacuum valves. Okay, developed the first arc valve, then first vacuum tubes, vacuum diodes, triodes. Okay, then we have other huge devices. Whatever the device, whatever the names you see here, like the vacuum diodes. Okay, then MOSFET, UJT, GTO, IGBT, thyristor, transistors. Okay, they all fall under the category of power electronics. Okay, here you can see some of them. Okay, different types of switches, they are called a power electronic switch. We call different names we have based on these switches only the production is been done. Okay, this is the symbol, and this is how the figures for the practically the image will look like. Okay, then this is the main important part of how the classification of the power electronic devices has been done. So power electronic devices, they fall under again the semiconductor devices. Okay, there is nothing like called as a power electronics is something different from the semiconductor. No, all the semiconductor devices can also be the power electronic devices. Okay, so that is why they have written as power semiconductor device. Then they have divided into two terminal devices and three terminal devices. Okay, just like two, like anode. Okay, I'll just come to that. Okay, what are the two terminal devices? We see diode, PN junction diode is a two terminal. One is anode, another is cathode. Okay, and then we have a Schottky diode. This is another type of diode we have. Okay, then a three terminal device, we have a MOSFET. Okay, then we have JFET, source, gate and drain. We have IGBT, similar. We have BJTs. Okay, then we have thyristor. In thyristor also, we have anode, cathode and gate terminal. Okay, so based on the majority and the minority charge carriers, or based on the their construction mechanisms, okay, the majority and the minority charge carriers will be different. Okay, for all the devices, or for all the semiconductor devices. Okay, so this is how the huge classification of the power electronics devices is been done in electronics. Okay, it is not like that. Okay, we do only study about the programming part. There is nothing there in the electronics. Okay, the electronics has been evolved in such a vast such a vast field where you can study anything, okay, of your interest. Okay, so this is how classification has been done in power electronics. Okay, so in my next class I will tell again in more detail how the power electronics has been evolved. Okay, thank you.